Hi, this is Dr. A with your medical terminology video on the digestive system pathologies. Alright, let's start with the oral cavity pathology. An aphthous ulcer is a painful ulcer in the mouth of unknown origin. It is commonly called a canker sore. It's possible that it's caused by a virus. A cleft lip is a congenital anomaly, so something you were born with. In which the upper lip and the jawbone fail to fuse in the midline and it leaves a gap. And this is a concern for babies because it might interfere with their feeding. And then a cleft palate is a congenital anomaly, so they're born with it again, in which the roof of the mouth has a split or a fissure. Again, can interfere with the feeding of the baby. The dental caries are a decay and a disintegration of the teeth. It is caused by bacteria. It is also known as a tooth cavity. Gingivitis is an inflammation of the gums. Herpes labialis is a viral infection of the lip by the herpes simplex virus type 1. It is also called a fever blister or a cold sore. Periodontal disease is a disease of the supporting structures of the teeth, including the gums and the bones. It is the most common cause of tooth loss. Sialadenitis is an inflammation of the salivary gland. Next, we're moving to the pharynx and esophagus. So esophageal varices are enlarged and swollen varicose veins in the lower end of the esophagus. The rupture results in serious hemorrhage or bleeding into the esophagus and into the stomach. And is often caused by liver issues because of the circulation of the tie between the two. So usually if you see esophageal varices, you want to go check out what's going on with the liver. Gastroesophageal reflux disease, or GERD, is a condition in which the acid from the stomach flows backward into the esophagus, which causes inflammation and pain. It causes heartburn, etc. Pharyngoplagia is a paralysis of the throat muscle. Gastric carcinoma, we're into the stomach pathologies now. Gastric carcinoma is a cancerous tumor in the stomach. Gastritis is inflammation of the stomach. Gastroenteritis is inflammation of the stomach and small intestine, and a hiatal hernia is a protrusion of the stomach through the diaphragm and into the thoracic cavity. It is also called a diaphragmatocele. A peptic ulcer, or PUD, is an ulcer in the lower portion of the esophagus, in the stomach, or in the duodenum. It is thought to be caused by the acid in gastric juices, but it is a result actually of Helicobacter pylori infection, which is a bacteria that can withstand the acidity of the stomach, and it can burrow through the lining, the protective mucus lining of the stomach, and cause an ulcer, which causes pain. And so this is what a peptic ulcer will also appear right here. We have gastric juices are released into the stomach. If it's a stomach ulcer, it'll be in the stomach. Duodenal ulcer will be right here in the duodenum. And the acid secretions further break down the lining of the stomach that's been already eroded by the bacteria, and that forms an ulcer. And if it eats away into the area where the circulation is, then you can have a bleed. Okay, so now we're into the small intestine and the large intestine pathology. So an anal fistula is an abnormal tube-like passage or connection from the surface around the anal opening directly into the rectum. Appendicitis is an inflammation of the appendix. Bowel incontinence is the inability to control defecation. Celiac disease is an autoimmune condition that affects the small intestine. It is caused by a reaction to eating gluten, which is contained in wheat products. The symptoms include bloating, pain, diarrhea, and nutritional deficiencies. Because of the inflammation, the nutrient absorption doesn't happen as well. Colorectal carcinoma is a cancerous tumor that originates in the colon or the rectum. Crohn's disease is another chronic inflammatory bowel disease. It primarily affects the ileum and or the colon. It affects all layers of the bowel wall, and it results in scarring and thickening. It is also called regional ileitis. Diverticulitis is an inflammation of a diverticulum, which is an outpouching of the gut. It often results from food being trapped inside. So there's a pouch, food gets lodged inside, especially things like nuts and seeds or things that have little seeds like strawberries or raspberries. Corn also can get lodged in these pouches, and then that causes diverticulitis or inflammation. And diverticulosis is a condition of having these diverticula or these outpouching in the guts, and it can lead to diverticulitis. This is what it looks like. So you can see normally it should be this way, right? The lining right there. And then this is a diverticulum right there. And if food gets stuck in there, then you can get an infection. I mean, this can get really bad. So, and it can, if it's not tended to, it can cause serious health problems. Dysentery is a disease that is characterized by diarrhea, often with mucus and blood, severe abdominal pain, fever, and dehydration. So the main treatment for that is making sure that people are hydrated properly. Enteritis is an inflammation of the small intestine. Hemorrhoids are varicose veins in the rectum and anus, and it can cause bleeding. Ileus is severe abdominal pain with the inability to pass stool, vomiting, and abdominal distension as a result of intestinal blockage. Unfortunately, some of that vomiting at first might be just stuff from the stomach, but then it can be stuff from the intestines that's coming back up. Inguinal hernia is a protrusion of a loop of small intestine into the inguinal or groin region through a weak spot in the abdominal wall. Infants can be born with that too. Intussusception is a result of the intestine slipping or telescoping into another section of the intestine just below it. So it kind of telescopes in like that. It makes this fold. The book has a good illustration. Irritable bowel syndrome, or IBS, is a disturbance in the function of the intestine from unknown causes. The symptoms include abdominal discomfort, alteration in bowel activity, etc. It's kind of a catch-all term for all of the things that can go wrong with the gut. So you can have irritable bowel syndrome and it end up being diverticulitis. It could be Crohn's. It could be ulcerative colitis. You could even have celiac disease. So if you have irritable bowel syndrome, you definitely should get to the root of it. Polyposis is the presence of small tumors called polyps. They are present in the mucous membrane of the large intestine, and it could be precancerous. So this is what they look for when they're doing a colonoscopy. This is what a polyp looks like. They're doing a colonoscopy, and they're using a wire loop to cut it off to analyze it, but also just to remove it, just in case it does turn into cancer. Proctoptosis is a prolapse or drooping rectum and anus. So prolapse, like almost like it's like falling out of, it's not being held into place anymore, so it just falls down. Ulcerative colitis is a chronic inflammatory condition that results in numerous ulcers on the lining of the colon. It is also called inflammatory bowel disease, or IBD. A volvulus is a condition in which the bowel twists upon itself, causing an obstruction. So if you can imagine a section of bowel that just twists, and then that gets blocked, that causes an obstruction. That could cause all kinds of problems that have to be fixed with surgery. All right, cholecystitis is an inflammation of the gallbladder, most commonly caused by gallstones. And cholelithiasis is the presence of gallstones, and they may or may not cause symptoms. Cirrhosis is a chronic liver disease that is associated with failure of the liver to function properly, and the cirro means yellow, and so you'll see the yellowing of the jaundice, yellowing of the skin. And because of the liver not working, not being able to process the bile, and so it backs up. It was actually not being able to process bilirubin, which is what causes the cirrhosis. But it can have many different causes. Hepatitis is a inflammation of the liver, usually due to a viral infection, although you can also have toxic hepatitis from drug overdoses. Hepatoma is a liver tumor, and pancreatitis is an inflammation of the pancreas. Now, pancreatitis can be life-threatening, so especially if it is acute pancreatitis. This is a gallbladder specimen with multiple gallstones. You can see them all over the place, but a bunch of them. And gallstones are usually calcified cholesterol crystals that come into stones. And so these are the common sites for gallstones. So we have into the gallbladder, the cystic duct, the duct from the liver, the hepatic duct here, and the common bowel duct. And if it blocks this common bowel duct to where it joins with the pancreatic duct, then it can cause pancreatitis also. So anyway, so that wraps up all of our pathologies for the gastrointestinal tract.